So, Tony, we're in beautiful San Antonio, a city that you know, raised you from a teenager to a man, and you've had a lot of success here. Why are we here?
Because I'm going to retire. So that's why I want you to come. I wanted to tell you first. I decided that I'm not going to play basketball anymore.
What ultimately brought you to that decision?
A lot of different stuff. But at the end of the day, I was like, if I can't be Tony Parker anymore and I can't play for a championship, I don't want to play basketball anymore.
When did you realize you couldn't be Tony Parker anymore?
Well, last season, you know, it was very different for me. I had a great time in Charlotte, but at the same time, it's very different for me because I was for 17 years, you know, with the Spurs. And so I knew that time changed, and I was being very nostalgic and being away from the family too, you know, that played a little bit of a role. And so I came to a conclusion that it was just time to move on. I have a lot of great stuff in my life, a beautiful family, beautiful kids. And so I wanted to, you know, spend more time with them.
When did you, was it a game? Was it a moment? When did you start thinking that, okay, it's time?
No, it was just at the end of the season. Just at the end of the season, I just knew it was time.
How did you come to peace with it?
I don't know. It's funny because it's more my family and my friends. They're like, oh, come on, do one more. Do one more. Me, I'm in peace with it. It's been a long time that I've been in peace with that decision because I prepare myself for that too with all the stuff that I'm doing, the two teams I own in France and my international school opening in September. I have so many stuff going on that I've always been in peace with that decision that when it comes, you know, I'll be ready to leave, you know, the young guys, you know, the basketball game is for young guys. So that's why for me, I understand very early that when it's time to come, I'll be fine with it.
Now, a couple years ago, you were pretty adamant to me you were going to play 20 seasons.
Yes, of course. And I wanted to play 20 seasons, and I still think I can play. You know, I had a good season with the Hornets, and I was healthy. But at the same time, if it's not with the Spurs, now I don't see any reason to play, 20 seasons.
What was the difference between playing with the Spurs and playing with the Hornets? I remember you telling me a couple times, it's not as fun. And I think you meant from a competitive standpoint.
Oh, yeah, from competitive, of course.
Yeah, possibly competing for a championship standpoint. Talk about the season with the Hornets and how it was different.
But you just said everything. It's different because when you don't play for a championship, when you used to, for 17 years, every year that I started with the Spurs, I really thought we had a good chance to win the championship. And so it was very weird to arrive to your team and you're like, there's no way we're going to win the championship.
Yeah.
And even if I had a great time and the Charlotte players, they were great with me and they were great guys. At the end of the day, I play basketball is to win something. Yeah. And it's been like that with the national team when we try to compete for a gold medal or with the Spurs to win a championship. And if I don't play for a championship, I feel like, why are we playing? And so that's why it was very different for me mentally to focus and get motivated to play a game that I love, but because I want to win something.
You know, this season, Dirk and Dwayne Wade, like everybody had a great goodbye to him. In hindsight, do you wish you did that?
Not at all. It's funny because my brothers asked me that, you didn't want to do like Dwayne and Dirk? And I said, no, because it's not on the Spurs jersey. So for me, it's different. You know, Dwayne did it with the Miami jersey, Dirk with the Dallas jersey. So it was nice there. Their end of their careers, but for me it was kind of different because I was in with Charlotte, so I didn't feel like the need of having a goodbye. For me, the goodbye will be when my jersey will be retired or other in the Hall of Fame if one day I can be with Timmy and Manu, but not in the last game. You know, I didn't really care about that.
So what do you remember about your last game?
I don't even remember what was my last game.
Like, was it set to battle to you?
I don't remember because I didn't even know when it was going to be my last game.
Okay. So when the season ended.
No, but when the season ended, I knew I was going to pretty much, I didn't think I was going to come back. But as the season was going on, I didn't know when was my last game because if we qualified for the playoff, I was going to play, you know, in the playoffs and stuff.
And so the last game of the season, when you took off your jersey, you were like, this is the last time. And
yeah, of course.
But nobody else knew, right?
Yeah, nobody else knew. But I say it's last time, but I was like, okay, 90% chance, you know, it'd be maybe my last game. I still kept the little room just in case that after a month and a half, I'd be like, oh, you know what? I still want to do that last year. We have a game in Paris, you know, and stuff like that. But after a month and a half, I still feel like, you know, I think it's the right time. Yeah. You know, I did everything I wanted to accomplish in my career. And everything that I accomplished in my career was even better than every dream I had when I was a kid. I was dreaming about the NBA, playing in the NBA, and my career was even better. So I feel very blessed that, you know, most of the guys who play sports, who play in basketball, they will never experience winning a championship. Yeah. And I was blessed enough to experience that four times and being MVP. So it's nothing else I can do.
Well, what do you think about your resume now? What you were able to do?
When I sit down, I feel very blessed and to have great teams, great teammates, great coach. What we had was very special. And it's funny because that whole year in Charlotte, you realize even more that what we had was very, very special. We were so close, you know, as teammates. And I was playing tennis with Timmy and Manu, and we was like talking about the old days. And you just realize, you know, how special was that 17 years together and all the wins and being the best duo of playoff history wins mm-hmm. and best trio, like all the records. Like now I'm starting to realize a little bit everything we accomplished.
Them retiring in recent years, what kind of impact did that have on you?
Timmy and Manu?
Yeah.
It had a little impact, but at the same time, I still, like I told you in many interviews, yeah. I thought I was going to play my 20 seasons, yeah. you know, with the Spurs. But you know, talking with Timmy and talking with Manu, that's for sure, you know, helped a little bit. Like, okay, I'm ready for this. You know, Timmy and Manu is not playing.
Yeah.
It's not the same.
Do they know?
Yeah, they know. Of course they know.
Yeah. What did they say?
They know before I talk to you.
They should.
Yeah. They were like, are you sure? You know, are you sure? And I was like, yeah, I'm sure. And so they're like, if you're sure, it's like, man, I'm so happy for you. So happy for you. We had a great run and can't wait to beat you up on tennis and spending more time together.
So you told them over a game of tennis?
No, I told them lunch with Timmy and Manu. We talked on the phone, and then when he played tennis, I told him.
What was that time with them like? I mean, because you guys are always going to be remembered together.
Yeah, we're always going to be remembered together. But it was great to share that moment with them. And like you said, it's crazy. Like, we came from three different backgrounds, and to come together like this and to see Timmy jersey retired and then Manu. It was very emotional to have Manu's jersey retirement, and you go through all the moments and you think about what you're going to say. Yeah. It was just nice to share that moment with them.
What do you think your retirement jersey day is going to be like? You thought about that much?
No, not really. But I don't know. It's going to be hard to imagine. But it's going to be the last time that we can celebrate, you know, the big three in that era. So I hope it's going to be a special night for everybody.
Yeah. Have you told Coach Popovich?
I told Coach Pop, yeah. I went to see him.
So you make the rounds, met
them. Yeah, like the guys that, you yeah. know, that I don't want them to know, like out of the blue like this. So he was happy for me. He was very happy for me.
He wasn't trying to re-sign you and bring you back?
No.
who else did you talk to help you with this decision?
Then my family and my friends, mm-hmm. and my wife, obviously.
Yeah.
A small circle, not too many people.
Yeah.
And then my good friend Mark Spears, you know, to organize everything.
Michael Jordan, mm-hmm. I assume you told him.
Mm-hmm.
What was that conversation like, and what did he have to say?
It was good. You understand. You know, I think it's for everybody. They're just happy for me. When I told Coach JB, he was just happy for me.
Yeah.
Happy for me because, like, I had good career and been healthy most of my career, and so they just. Happy that when they ask me, it's like, are you in peace, you know, with that decision?
Yeah.
And yes, I'm in peace with that decision. I feel very good about the decision, and I know that I'm not gonna miss basketball.
How's your body feel?
Great. Like I told you, I can easy play two more years. Easy. It's not even like physically, I feel fine.
Yeah.
And especially with the role that I have, you know, being a backup and the way JB will manage me this year, I can easily do two more years.
Yeah.
But for me, I don't want to play just to play. And I never play basketball like that. I never play basketball for money, and I never play basketball for just to have fun. I want to win.
So what does retirement look like for you?
Whew, I'm gonna be busy. My team just won. My women's team just won, so we celebrate our first championship. My men's team, hopefully, we're going to finals.
And say the name of the team. So
Asvel. The city is Lyon. Lyon. It's the second biggest city in France. I've been owning the team since 2014, and so it's a big project. And so we're going to enter the EuroLeague next year with Asvel. And then my academy is opening in September. So that's going to be my international school. So that's my way to give back to my country, give back to the young generation. So I'm very, very excited about that new project.
So the international school is a basketball school, or is it more than
that? No, it can be anybody. It can be anybody coming to the school.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And it's just a school. It's not
exactly
a basketball factory.
No, it's not a basketball academy, no. Okay.
So are you going from United States?
No, I'm going to live in San Antonio. It'll be home. That will always be home. So I'm definitely going to stay in San Antonio, and then I'll just travel.
What does the city of San Antonio mean to you?
Home. It's home. It's home. I arrived here. I was 19 years old, and they embraced me, and they treated me like their son, and it's always going to be home. It's family.
Yeah. How about the fans here too?
Oh, I always have great memories. You know, when I came back, I still remember the day, January 14, when I came back with the Hornets. It was unbelievable, the love that they showed to that game. Yeah. I felt like my jersey was being retired. Yeah. It was unbelievable. And I can't wait for the real date to see them, you know, one more time and celebrate with them. I always say they're the best fans in the NBA, and we won 4 championships together, and I always remember it.
Are you glad you went to Charlotte, or do you wish you would have? Because you could have re-signed with the Spurs.
No, I'm glad I went to Charlotte. I was very happy I went to Charlotte. It was a great experience. I met some great people, and I really appreciate Michael giving me an opportunity, and Mitch Kupchak and JB. It was a great, great time. The guys were great, and so I don't regret anything because I really wanted to play, and I really wanted to show that I can still play. And I had a good season. I was healthy, so I don't regret anything. It was a great experience. Yeah. And it's funny in a way. I feel like the fact that I went to Charlotte, I feel like in San Antonio, they love me more. Because it was always, you know, Timmy and Manu, and I was always the little one who always beat on Tony. If Spurs not winning, it's Tony. Because I'm the point guard. And I felt by leaving, you know, I feel like they appreciate me more now. It's funny.
There's not a lot of people of color that are running teams or owning teams in the NBA. With the experience that you're getting in France, could you see yourself eventually coming back to the NBA, perhaps as a general manager, a president?
Yeah, for sure. That's one of my dreams. Right now I'm focusing, you know, on Asvel, and I'm having a great experience. We're building a new arena right now, and we're going to enter the EuroLeague, and the EuroLeague is growing very fast. But the ultimate is be one day be a owner in the NBA, and so I'm already having talks, you know, with different people, and they're looking at what I'm doing, you know, in France, and so I definitely have the experience, and I love doing it. It takes a lot of work, but I love it. Yeah. I love it. So maybe one day, when if it's the right opportunity, and it's something that I definitely want to do, I'm just gonna wait for the right opportunity.
Yeah, what was it like to be an owner?
I love it. Because I don't want to just do the basketball side. I like the business side too, the marketing, how to put people in the arena, work with the digital team, you know, and how we can make the experience better in the arena for the fan and all that kind of stuff. And I love the basketball side too, you know, scouting, finding the young guy. Like right now, the point guard of my team, Theo Maledon, he's going to be top 10 in the draft, and not this year, but the year after. Yeah. He's like blossoming. And so that's that part too, I love it too. But I like the global, I like to have the global vision.
So you're involved in every aspect of the team?
Oh, of course, yeah. Everybody who gets recruited, you know, I recruit them, negotiate contracts and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. Going from the 28th pick in the first round to a starting point guard, to 4 championships, to MVP, the first European Finals MVP. Could you even dream of this?
No, like I told you. What
were your expectations when you first came into that?
Like I told you earlier, my career was better than any dream that I had when I was a kid. And when I first arrived in NBA, I was like, man, if I can be a good little player, you know, be a good backup, you know. Yeah. I'll be happy with that. I was just happy to be in the NBA. I never thought I'd be, you know, a starter or be the youngest, you know, point guard to start in the NBA or the first European to be NBA MVP finals. I never dreamed about that.
What impact do you think you had on France and Europe?
I hope that I had a good impact, you know, with Dirk and Powell and Kirilenko. When we arrived, you know, after that it exploded, you know, and now you have, I don't know, more than 80 international players, 12 French guys in the NBA. Yeah. So I always took it seriously, my role of being a good ambassador for French basketball.
I think people just assume you had a silver spoon because your dad was a pro basketball player. Mm-hmm. What's the truth of your upbringing and how that led you to go to college, not go to college, but go to the NBA?
I think people don't realize that I grew up with nothing. You know, we had nothing growing up, and it was rough times, but I think that's what gave me the motivation, you know, to make it in life, because I wanted my family to have a better life. And I think Pop saw that very early in me when he first interviewed me. I think that's why Pop was so hard on me, because he knew that he can't go even over the line with me, because he knew that I will stay motivated and wanted to make it whatever happens. And he threw everything at me, and I was always there and ready to go.
Yeah. How tough was it, dude? What were some of the toughest things you went through as a kid?
Well, not having food in the fridge, having people coming in your house and take the TV because we didn't pay on time, you know, the bills. All that stuff, you know, stays in your head, and you remember, and you never want that to happen to you.
Yeah. How does that impact you now with your family? I mean, obviously, finances isn't an issue.
I think now it's going to be opposite now. I have to explain to my kids that, you know, not everybody lives like that, and you have to be respectful. Don't take it for granted, because anything in life can go fast. And if you disrespect people or you don't, you know, appreciate life, bad stuff will happen to you. So that's why I always live my life like that. You know, try to be a good guy, be, you know, loyal, and be... you know, just be a good guy, because I'm like, what goes around comes back around, you know, karma and stuff like that. So just try to put good values to them.
Yeah. How do you reflect back on your decision at such a young age? Like, you could have went to college. You could have went, UCLA is a great school.
It's a great school.
But to make that decision at that age to help your family, like, how?
But for me, I was like, I want to play against older guys anyway. I feel like I'm improving faster if I play with older guys. And so that's why college was good, but I was like, I want to be professional, I want to help my family, and I want to play against older guys. I feel like it will accelerate my basketball skills.
What is your greatest memory of your career? And your greatest disappointment?
My greatest memory, I will say the 4 championships, obviously, and the gold medal with the French national team, because it was the first time in the French basketball history that we win a gold medal. And the biggest disappointment, I will say, Game 6 against Miami in 2013. That's the biggest disappointment. And then with the national team, I'll say 2005 against Greece. We were up 7 with 40 seconds, and we lost the game. So that would be that could have been, you know, my first gold medal back in the day. So that'd be the 2 toughest losses.
So go. I hate to bring up that Heat game. Mm-hmm. But do you guys still talk about it? Do you, Tim?
No, not at all.
Is there a reason why you just, was it that painful? Or?
Yeah, it's painful. And I think because we came back in 2014 and we won it, you know, that erase kind of, not erase, that's not the word. It's just we make up for it kind of. That was maybe a great opportunity to do a back-to-back. I think it showed a lot of character, the way we lost in 2013 and the way we came back, and to come back like that and play the same team, and we basically destroyed them in 2014, playing the, you know, the beautiful game, and we won all the games by 20. I think that made it up a little bit.
Yeah, the moment when you were finals MVP and you had to, I remember the French flag. Mm-hmm. What did that moment in your career mean to you?
But that was like it was just surreal to me, because it was still Timmy's team and Timmy's franchise, and just to have Timmy's support during the finals to just take over, and him deferring, you know, to me, because the matchups, the advantage was at my position. That just shows, you know, the way we were thinking with the Spurs. take less money, stay together, and whoever's going, let's play for him. And if nobody let their ego be above the team. Yeah. And so when I look at my MVP trophy, I always remember Timmy like pushing me to get that trophy and take over in the finals.
What could people learn about the Spurs dynasty?
That we had no ego. We had no ego and we didn't let money, you know, affect, you know, our dynasty.
What we missed the most?
Winning. It never gets old. And so that's why it was nice to win with my women's team, because winning championships is hard to explain to somebody. How do you feel? You know, and as a player, it was great to win championship. And then now as an owner, when you build from scratch, you know, everything, I'm more happy for them. You know, it's priceless to see their face, you know, but yeah. It never gets old. Winning championships never gets old.
So what are you going to do now that you're retired that you wouldn't do because you were playing?
Oh, a lot of stuff. I think one of the first things, ski. I want to ski.
In the French Alps?
French Alps, yes. Yep, on the ski.
What else? Anything else?
Right now, on top of my
like
head.
Are you still eating good? Or are you like?
Yeah, I'm still eating good. Yeah, I'm still eating good. Top of my head, jump off the plane, you know, parachutes.
You want to do that?
Mm-hmm.
Where?
Anywhere.
Should do it over San Antonio, right?
Why not? Because you just threw me a question. I was just top of my head. That's where things would come out.